Hey everyone, welcome back to Let's Play Super House of Dead Ninjas. I'm Duke of the Bump. Hopefully y'all enjoyed my frenetic ass commentary in that last video. Kind of a lot going on in this game. It's a little difficult to narrate when you're facing the timer, you know, staring down that 30 second timer. So in the last video I sort of speculated about the upgrades, whether I actually unlock them or if I only unlock the ability to get them. And I'm pretty sure I actually unlock these. I think that text over that lady's head says what you have to do to unlock these. And I think I did all this stuff. Because under weapons, for example, like with nunchucks, it says bump off Spite to get this. I'm pretty sure Spite was a boss that I killed. And obviously I can go ahead and use this. And then cut off the heads of 10 enemies and you can have this. And I'm pretty sure I did that as well. I'm going to stick with the sword for now, just to try to get my bearings in this game. I'll go ahead and switch to this beefed up shuriken because it seems like there's no reason not to. And these upgrades, I assume these are just always on, so I should have 10 more shurikens or whatever projectile I equip later on, and an extra magic. So once I start the game, I can determine if that's actually the case. And then these, I'm not sure what a rare pickup timer is. I guess that's something I haven't found yet. But it allows you to actually bump the timer above 30 seconds, which is pretty cool. Alright, enough monkeying around. Let's go on ahead and get started. Oh hey, I don't have to start on the roof anymore. I can just jump straight to the Abyss of Nature. That's interesting. I didn't realize you could do that. Well, I guess there's no reason to start on the roof again, because it's not like I really have to, you know, pick up power-ups or anything. Like in Spelunky, for example, I don't use the shortcuts just because I want all the resources you get in the earlier levels. But in this game, since there's a cap on the number of resources you can have, it doesn't seem like it would make that much of a difference. So I'll go ahead and start here. Alright, so timer starts immediately. No tutorial in this one. Okay, so that's a named enemy, I guess. So I unlocked something special from that. Alright, I do have two magic now instead of one, so that would bear out my theory that that I already have those upgrades. Didn't seem like the monkey ran from me, though. It seemed like it ran through me. Right, still getting unlocked pretty frequently, it seems like. Not sure if that little pause I get when I defeat enemies sometimes means anything special, or if it's just slowdown. There is an option in the options menu to turn the slowdown off. That doesn't seem very skillful to me. Can I destroy these things? No, I guess not. But I left the slowdown on just to get the authentic experience. Okay, so that's a question mark. That's not even a letter. That's kind of interesting. I still have no idea what those pickups are for. Alright, so it seems like the level layout is getting... it's changing it up a little bit here. A lot more horizontality in this area. It's not just kind of going straight down. So I think I can use a bomb here. A little bit of, those are just normal tiles, I guess. Alright, so is there any way I can... Yeah. Okay, so there's like a slide move. Or not a slide, but like sort of a duck walk. Not walk like a duck, but duck and walk at the same time. Alright, so those monkeys don't seem to care about...
Time extension.
Ooh. Okay, so I guess that was one of the rare time pickups. Got some health there, so that's good. I have to be more careful around these big guys. I have to remember they take two hits to kill instead of just one. And those guys, those are the bomb droppers. I have to remember them as well. So I think I can bomb here. Get that E and that money. Money doesn't seem to do anything in this game. I guess it's just points.
Do these actually hurt?
No, they just slow me down. Okay. Okay, so there's another named enemy. I think I will make use of one of my bombs here. Alright, so the time extension isn't permanent. Like, normal time icons still only fill that back up to 30, not 60. Oh crap. Dang it! I knew I would need to get two hits on that guy. Man, that's a really gruesome continue screen, but the continuing feels pretty satisfying. It's pretty nice that you start off exactly where you died when you continue. So I don't even need the health yet, because I have not gotten hit since the respawn. Oh god. Trying to make a mental note of the things. Okay, so he's actually carrying a bomb. It kind of looks like his head. Oh crap. Unless you look closely. So I just kind of have to be on the lookout for that. Anything past the swamp? No. Looks like they don't, like, go back up or anything. So once they drop, you can just jump over them, and it's all good, probably. More shurikens. Okay, another boss. Neat. The Colossal Ox. His name is Doom. No time limit on the boss, so that's good. Jeez! Alright, so I guess I have to jump when he hits the ground. And not be anywhere near these statues, ideally. I didn't even notice the boss had a health meter down there. Guess I should, pay better attention to that stuff. Can I destroy the statues? No. Seems like it's very difficult to hit him with those statues there. Man, it just does not skip a beat. It just jumps you right back into the game. Alright, so I don't think I actually have to jump. I wasn't getting stunned. I was just getting hit by those statues. Crap. Well, I know one thing I can do. Bring out some magic on this guy. Jeez! Dang it. I'm very used to playing Abyss Odyssey still, because I play that game a lot, so I have to get used to not being able to dodge with the L and R buttons. And that was all my continues. Wow, that guy seemed tough. I don't really know how to deal with him. Maybe I can blow those statues up with bombs? But it doesn't really seem like you have enough time to do that. So I broke my old high score. Friend kills too. I still don't know what that means. I'm not sure who the friends were that I killed. I also didn't last that long. But to be fair, I was a lot deeper in the dungeon this time, or in the tower, I guess. Mm-hmm. It's kind of weird that you start at the top of the tower and work your way down. That's sort of the opposite of what you would expect. Alright, so what did I unlock here? Wind magic from the bowels. Oh god. Sure, I'll try it. And let's try a different weapon this time. I'll go with the chucks. I don't know what instant attack means. I guess it just means... Like, maybe there's a tiny pause with the katana that the nunchucks don't have? I'm not sure. Chose location of nearby items, okay. Oh, I unlocked a new suit color too, pink. Let's go with fuchsia this time. Change it up a little bit. I'll do pink at a later time. Makes monkeys flee from the flare. Yeah, I'm not sure these are actually... Well, I guess this one's activated because I did increase my time to 60 seconds. Just the monkey evasion didn't seem to do much. Alright, let's go ahead and do one more run here. Didn't get any new upgrades, but that's okay. Alright, let's try out these nunchucks and my new magic. Oh, okay. So it's like a circular attack. The description didn't really make it sound like that. That's Electric Toast. Actually, it seems a little slower than the katana. So the description was a little misleading. Is this a... Okay. I thought maybe it was a friend since it wasn't coming after me, but it wasn't. No one knows how Smither the Skeleton gets into treasure rooms. Frankly, we prefer him to leave them alone. Alright. I assume that means something. What's that skull? Can I get back up there? You fool. Okay, so apparently the skull is bad. Which is shocking, I know. But I didn't see it before, so I had to pick it up and at least try it. Crap, wrong button. Okay, so that's kind of cool. Seems a little bit more useful than the lightning magic. Trying to get those without hitting the spikes. Oh, that thing can attack me through the floor. Oh, the monkey bane is an item I can pick up. Okay, so it's kind of like the Binding of Isaac, where with those pickups you have to unlock them and then you can pick them up at some point in the dungeon. That's interesting. But the upgrades I think are always in effect. Because I have the projectile and the magic upgrades. Speaking of magic. Apparently I'm a good ninja. Oh jeez. So it seems like the clocks are more likely to show up if I'm about to run out of time. I'm not sure if that's the case or if I'm just getting lucky. It's possible that I'm just timing it right. Gnarly. Crap. Oops. Shouldn't have gone after the question mark. So I'm not sure if it's like a Wiz and Liz situation where running out of time makes the extra time show up, or if it's just working out that way. Aw, I chose Boiler. Alright, Bombman. I see your bomb. I see your bomb and I'll raise your shuriken. Okay, so I got the monkey bane, that's cool. Again, I'm not sure if they like... This is not good. I'm not sure if I lost it when I died or if they stack or what. Alright, so I can blow those things up with bombs, but I'm not sure that'll help me during the boss. Not sure if I would have had time to, if I would have had time to bomb those statues. Okay, so I cannot shuriken that statue. I tried that several times during the boss and it didn't work out. Oh god. Who's this guy? Oh man, I thought it might be a friend. Trying to figure out where those friend kills are coming from. Maybe that means, like, friends on my Steam friends list who played this game and they died in that area or something. I'm not sure. I think it would be more than, like, two if that was the case. Crap. I am getting dangerously low on health again. I'm assuming there will be, like, health upgrades and stuff, too, down the line. Which would be pretty nice. It seems, the spirit of this game seems pretty similar to Rogue Legacy. Where, you start out very weak, and then you build up upgrades that allow you to continue the game. Downward slash can destroy multiple bosses in a row. Yep, I figured that out. Appreciate it, though. Oh wait, maybe that was my friend, because it was like a ninja. I'm not sure. Alright, is this gonna be the same boss? No, it's a different guy. Torment, the unstoppable turtle. Well, he was unstoppable, alright. Alright. Come on, Torment. See what you got. Alright, gotta be careful not to jump into those spikes. Oh, I bet I have to hit him in the back. That looks like a very weak spot. Which is ironic for a turtle. You think the back would be this tough spot. Man, that's a very difficult jump to make. I wonder if there are upgrades that increase like your jump height and stuff. Crap. Aw, it only... I was hoping all three of them would be launched at him. Alright, this is very close. If I just mess up just one of these jumps, that's the end. That must have hurt. Yes, it did hurt. Alright, I don't want to sit through that. That's horrifying. Okay, well, let's see what I unlocked that time. Didn't even come close to my high score or anything. Yeah, it seems like the friend kills is 2 every time. I don't know what that is. Okay, I unlocked an upgrade. That's cool. Max life plus 1. Yeah, so I was right. There are life upgrades. I wonder, since these are grouped like this, I wonder like if these are all... Oh yeah, you can actually see what they are at the bottom even before you unlock them. I'm smart. So the max lives you can have is 9, it looks like. And then timer upgrade, projectile upgrade, bomb upgrade, magic upgrade. Okay, that's cool. It seems like each of these is based on unlocking some sort of challenge, which might be good, might be bad, I'm not sure. That's how a lot of the stuff in Binding of Isaac worked too. There were certain tasks that you had to do to unlock the stuff. In fact, that might be how all the drops were. I forget. So this is sort of like Rogue Legacy meets the Binding of Isaac meets, like, I don't even know, Super Meat Boy or something? It seems like, I mean, it controls really well, you know, it feels really cool running through these levels and stuff. I'm really liking this game so far. It's tough, but hopefully I will be able to persevere. So the life upgrade just comes through dying X number of times, so these will just happen pretty much by themselves. This is based on what floor I reach. I thought I made it to floor 50. I thought I made it farther than this. I'm not sure. Survived for 5 minutes. I thought I survived for 10 minutes too. I thought my first run lasted at least 10 minutes. But maybe not. 15 minutes. Kill 100 monsters. So these will all unlock eventually, because these are just these are over time. Like, I don't have to kill 300 monsters in one run or anything. At least it doesn't look like it. Destroy 75 of those fiends with bombs. I guess by fiends it just means enemies in general. Okay. Defeat any minion with only your katana. Oh, the minions must be the bosses. So I haven't done that yet. So I guess these are all based on killing bosses or defeating bosses in a certain way. Go rage. Okay, so these aren't all boss stuff. DLC pack. Lame. Okay, so that'll about do it for this episode. I didn't make much progress, but I had fun. Tune in tomorrow, hopefully, for yet another update. Goodbye.